Hey y'all, welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name is Sierra and I post videos on this channel every single Friday. I post Christian BookTube content, so if you're into that kind of thing, I highly recommend pressing subscribe. Today I am going to be talking about The Hiding Place by Corrie Ten Boom. This is one of my favorite books ever. It is in like my list of, if I had to say like everybody should read these books once in their life, it would 100% make the top five in that list. I have read this book multiple times. I have actually been to The Hiding Place in Haarlem in the Netherlands. I just am so touched by this book. It means so much to me. Like, if I were running out of a burning building, I would save this book just so that I could read it again. Like, that is how much I love it. A quick synopsis of The Hiding Place is it is nonfiction. I would classify it as kind of autobiographical slash a memoir. It is written about Corrie Ten Boom by Corrie Ten Boom in the first person. All of the events in it are 100% true. They did happen. None of it is made up, though it does read like a novel. It's not organized or written like a novel, but the chapters in it read like one, with dialogue and actions and just the way things are described. I think people know what I mean when I say like it's written like a memoir. Those oftentimes read as novels, so that is definitely how The Hiding Place reads. It's not a super long book. What it is about, though, is super, super deep and touching. It follows the Ten Boom family through their experience in creating The Hiding Place in their little house in Haarlem, and then getting discovered and being sent to prison, and then Corrie and her sister Betsy are put in a concentration camp, and then it does follow Corrie's release from the concentration camp and what she does after being released to continue kind of the legacy of what the Ten Boom family did and provide a safe place for survivors like herself, and survivors, those being who she helped, the Jews. So that is basically what the book is about. It goes chronologically. It's not an easy read, although it is a shorter book. It is not easy. Every time I read it, it takes me a couple of days just because I absorb it and like I really think about it when I'm reading it. The subjects are obviously very hard, because it's set in World War II. It is about World War II, about the Holocaust, about the terror and fear and just utter dependency that the Ten Booms had to have on God, and the trust that they had to have in the network of people around them. And it just makes my head spin how the Ten Booms' faith like solidified their entire experience and everything that they did, and how they just constantly trusted him. Everything could have gone wrong so many times, but there are so many miracles within the book. I can think of like three or four right off the top of my head that I can remember being in the book, but I know there were far more. And then I learned about even more that weren't included when I visited The Hiding Place, and that was just so cool. I highly recommend doing that and reading the book in tandem. Obviously, not everyone is going to be able to go to Haarlem, but it was such a cool and not life-changing experience, but definitely it put a lot of things in perspective for me to be able to walk the house and see like, okay, this is where these events actually happened that I'd always only been able to picture in my mind. So the reason The Hiding Place touches me so much and it kind of impacts me is because every time I read it, I am just reminded of how much I take for granted. I always become so grateful to God and to others when I read this book, because the Ten Booms, Corrie, went through so much that the average human will never even experience like the slightest kinds of inconveniences or terrors that they did. They risked their lives for people that they didn't know, but they loved nonetheless. And that message is just it's so deep and it's just one to chew on. It's not just something I can like say and then move on. It's something that I have to think about every time I read it and think about how this family was afraid, but they would not just sit back and let the war happen. They would do something about it. They would join this network of people and they would create a safe haven, a hiding place for those who were far worse off than they ever were. Because the Ten Booms were Christians. They were not Jews. They could have just sat back and been fine the entire war, most likely. But they stepped in, they pitched in, and they saved, like, I'm sure, hundreds of people. That might be a stretch, but I'm sure they saved so many people. They saved lives, which is enough. Again, they just face things that the average person is never going to think about facing in their life. And it makes you so grateful for what you have and how, you know, you get up and you make food every single day. You don't have to wonder if you're going to be able to have food because you're in a concentration camp. You don't wonder if your medicine is going to run out. You can always go to the grocery store and get more. But like the Ten Boom family, the Corey and her sister Betsy, when they were in the concentration camp, they constantly worried about running out of medicine. And that was one of the miracles, is they never did, which is, it's just, I could probably talk about that for a long time, but that is the reason that it touched me so deeply. I could talk about other reasons, but that's the main one. It just makes me so grateful and really puts things in perspective. I have reread it multiple times. I want to say 4 times. It could be 5. And I'm so, so glad I've gotten the experience to visit the hiding place and let that visit impact me as well. It is a book that I 100% want to read again in the future. If you have read it, please let me know in the comments and tell me like what it means to you, if it touches you, something I didn't mention, because there were plenty of things I didn't mention. Yeah, I'd love to hear from other people about this book and talk about it, because it is just so, so phenomenal and amazing. I say that about a lot of books that I review on my channel, but I really want to stress that this is an absolute, like, need to read, not a must read, like, oh, it's a 5-star really good story. This is a heart-touching story that will stay with you long after you finish it. And that is why I wanted to talk about it. So let me know if you've read it. Let me know why you love it, because I'm sure you do. And thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more content like this, let me know in the comments and subscribe. That would be a great help. And I will see you next week for whatever video that is. Until then, bye.